Hello friends, welcome to EduTap. I welcome you all in the rapid session of general awareness. We'll be discussing the most important current affairs from 28th to 30th of May 2021. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and join our Telegram channel for the free data and the notification of our session. We are providing you daily exam booster of general awareness, ESI current affair report and indices friends. The superstar of the session are Pooja, Ganesh, Narendra Naidu, Vaishik Nair, Kapil Chaurasia, Arpita Pandey and Nilesh Suryavanshi who have given the right answer to the homework question below my video. And thank you so much friends for replying over there. So your question number one says, which of the following company has launched a co-innovation and advanced research center in Amsterdam? And the right answer to this question is friends option number C, that is Tata Consultancy Services. Now let's play with the option. I hope you remember with TCS that TCS has recently appointed your Sameer Shekhsaria as its chief financial officer. Point number one. Second friends, Wipro is here in the options and we'll discuss one or two points with Wipro. That Wipro friends, if you remember that Wipro has recently regained its position as the third largest Indian IT service company. Okay, by the market capitalization of 2.65 trillion. Now, what is this market capitalization? Friends, every company has shares, right? If we multiply these shares with the market value of these shares, then that thing is known as your market capitalization. So, in the terms of market capitalization, it regains its third position by surpassing the HCL Technologies. On the top, okay, it's TCS. Second position is of Infosys, third position is of Wipro and fourth position is of HCL Technologies. I hope this is clear. Let's discuss what the news says. Friends, TCS has launched a co-innovation and advanced research center in Amsterdam. Now, name of the center is TCS Peace Port Amsterdam. Now, it has been designed to help the customer to navigate their growth and their transformation journey, friends, and will serve as a hub for TCS team to co-innovate with your European customers. Now, additional information which I want to share here is friends, Peaceport Amsterdam is the third co-innovation center by the company after New York's and Tokyo. So they have launched a co-innovation center in New York also, co-innovation center is Tokyo also, and then they have launched a co-innovation center in Amsterdam also. I hope all these things are clear. So question number two, who among the following has been appointed as the Commerce Secretary, Government of India upon your superannuation of Anoop Vadhavan? So the right answer to this question is friends, option number C, that is BVR Subramaniam. Now friends, Josh J. Kathur has been appointed as the Executive Director of RBI. I hope you remember. So T. Ravi Shankar has been appointed as the 4th Deputy Governor of RBI. And friends, he'll be replacing B.P. Kanungo. Discussed everything in the previous sessions. Okay. If we talk about Narendra Batra, friends, he has been elected as the president of International Hockey Federation. Now, this International Hockey Federation's headquarters are in Switzerland. The name of the CEO is Thierry Weil, friends. And it has been founded on 7th of January 1924 in your Paris, France. Now with this France, I can make one more link that India and France bilateral exercise named Varuna, and this Varuna 2021 friends took place in the Arabian Sea. Subodh Kumar Jaiswal has been recently appointed as the director of CBI. We have discussed in the previous video only. So friends, Chief Secretary of Jammu and Kashmir, BVR Subramaniam has been appointed as the Commerce Secretary, Government of India. Okay, now I hope this is clear. Question number three friends. RBI has imposed a monetary penalty of rupees 10 crore on which of the following banks for irregularities found in its auto loan book? So the right answer to this question is your A, that is HDFC Bank. Now with this HDFC Bank, I can link one or more things that RBI has recently appointed Atanu Chakraborty as the part-time chairman of HDFC Bank. Friends, we have discussed this. Now, HDFC Bank has launched an chatbot Eva, friends. And I hope if you remember that this chatbot Eva will be helpful for the village level entrepreneurs. Their problems, their queries, all will be sorted out on these platforms. And basically, it has been made to strengthen their businesses. Okay. Now, friends, in the option, Kotak Mahindra Bank is present here. And we have discussed previously two appointments. One is Kotak Mahindra life insurance. One is Kotak Mahindra General Insurance. Now the MD and CEO of Kotak Mahindra Life Insurance is your Mahesh Balasubramaniam. And friends, your MD and CEO of Kotak Mahindra General Insurance is your Suresh Agrawal. We have discussed both these appointment previously also. Let's discuss what the news says. Now RBI is here, friends, and I hope you remember that RBI has recently opened a liquidity tap of 50,000 crores to banks so that these banks can further lend this money to the COVID centers for producing of vaccines, producing of oxygen or the things which are helpful or an emergency aid to fight against coronavirus. And under this liquidity tap, we have discussed this also, that your Bank of Baroda become the first public center bank to provide 500 crore rupees to Serum Institute of India to produce vaccines. And the headquarters of Serum Institute of India are in Pune, and the name of the CEO is Adar Poonawalla. Friends, I hope this is clear to you. We have discussed everything in our previous videos. This is just a drill to keep revising things, as multiple time revision is the only key to success, as I have told you earlier also. So RBI has, friends, imposed a monetary penalty of rupees 10 crore on your HDFC Bank. Okay, HDFC Bank. For irregularities found in its auto loan book. Okay, friends, I hope this is clear. Now, friends, with this RBI, I can link one more thing, that RBI has set up, friends, what? Regulation Review Authority 2.0. And it has made the head of Regulation Authority 2.0. Who has been made the head of this Regulation Authority 2.0, friends? Regulation Review Authority 2.0, the head was M. Rajeshwar Roy. Remember, his name also can be asked in the examination. So friends, next question number 4. Which of the following space agency will design Earth System Observatory to help address mitigate climate changes? So friends, the right answer to this question is your NASA. Okay, so now Roscosmos is the space agency of Russia, friends. India and Russia bilateral exercise name Indra. The capital of Russia is St. Petersburg and your Moscow, friends. I hope you remember. CNES is the space agency of France. India and France bilateral exercise name Varuna. And this Varuna 2021 recently took place in the Arabian Sea, which we have discussed in the previous videos. If we talk about JAXA, friends, it is the space agency between India and it is the space agency of Japan. If we talk about CNSA, it is the space agency of China. And friends, China capital Beijing. Now Russia and China are given here, and we have discussed in the previous video that Russia and China are together building the world biggest nuclear power plant in two Chinese cities. Okay, friends, Russia is given here. One more link I can make with Russia, that is Russia became the first country to launch 17,000 doses for COVID vaccine for animals. I hope all these things are clear and are done. So friends, NASA will design a new set of Earth focused mission. What is the purpose, friends? Why this has been designed? To provide a key information and guide people related to climate changes, disaster, forest fires, etc. If we know about all these things, obviously we can find out the preventive measure to tackle these situations. Okay, friends, next question number 5. Dash has received the International ENI Annie Award 2020 for research into renewable energy sources and energy storage. So the right answer to this question is option number D, that is Professor C.N.R. Roy. Now friends, Amartya Kumar Sen has also given one award. Okay, it's Spain's top award. Now you have to tell me the name of this award and for which field it has been presented to him in the homework section. So friends, let's move forward and discuss what the news says. So Bharat Ratna awardee, friends, Professor C.N.R. Roy has received the International ENI Award 2020. Now this award will be presented to him on 14th of October 2021 in the official ceremony of Quirinal Palace in Rome, friends. Okay, this was the point number one. Second thing, friends, this award, why he is getting this award? He is getting this award for the research into renewable energy sources, his energy storage, okay, and this award is also known as the Nobel Prize of Energy Research. Remember all these 2-3 points. Awards are also asked in your examination. So what is presenting, what has been presented him in the award, that is a cash prize and a specially minted gold medal. Okay friends, I hope it's clear. So let's move forward and see what question number 6 says. Bashar al-Assad, friends, has been re-elected as the president of which of the following countries? So the right answer to this question is option number D, that is, friends, is Syria. Let's discuss. So Bashar al-Assad, friends, will continue to serve as the president of Syria after winning the election for the 4th time. So friends, he have won the election. Okay, and for the 4th time, he'll be serving as the president of Syria. Now, the takeaway for the examination and question can be asked. The capital of Syria is Damascus and the currency is Syrian pound. So, question number 7 says, friends, which of the following film has won the Best Grand Jury Award for Best Feature Film at Indian Film Festival at Los Angeles? So, the right answer to this question is Sethuman. This film has won the friends Grand Jury Award for the best film. Okay. Now friends, those that watch me dream, we have discussed something related to this movie also. I hope you remember. If you don't, I'll tell you friends. Those that watch me dream is a short film which has been nominated, which has been selected for the non-fungible token friends, which has been minted for the NFT. I hope friends this is clear. So Tamil filmmaker friends Thamiz debut film your Sethuman won the Grand Jury Award for the best feature and your Karishma's debut Dubey's Bittu bagged the Grand Jury prize for best shot at the Indian Film Festival of Los Angeles. So remember these names friends. If a film or something gets award or is nominated for an award, that point becomes important for your examination, that this can also be asked for your examination. The question number 8 says, friends, Eric Carl passed away. He belonged to which of the following profession? If any obituary comes in the examination, point number 1, the profession of the person is very, very important. And if he is, you know, given some award, if he is honored with that some award, that is also important for your examination. So the right answer is, friends, he was option number A, that he was an author. Now, children picture book, friends, author. He was a children picture book author. Okay, he used to write books for small children. And illustrator Eric Carle, friends, he passed away. And he is the author of the famous classic book, that is The Very Hungry Caterpillar. It is a very famous book, friends, for children. Okay, this book was published by World Publishing Company Hamis Hamilton. Remember all 2-3 points related to this can be asked in your examination. So question number 9 says that has been removed as an ambassador of UN's environmental treaty. Friends, who has been removed as an ambassador of UN's environmental treaty? And the right answer is option number D, that is Randeep Hooda. Now, Kangana Ranaut is also given air in the option, friends, and Kangana Ranaut has been banned from Twitter. Remember this, we have discussed this news also. So, friends, actor Randeep Hooda has been removed as the ambassador of conservation of migratory species. Okay, conservation of migratory species of wild animal, United Nations Environment Treaty. Why he has been banned? Because, friends, he have passed some joke or, comment against former Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Mayawati. Therefore, for this reason, he has been, removed as an ambassador of CMS. The actor was appointed as the CMS ambassador of migratory species in February, friends, 2021 for 3 years. But now he has been removed from this post. World Hunger Day is observed globally on Dash, friends. You have to tell the date and the right answer is 28th of May. Now on 28th of May, World Hunger Day is observed. So let's discuss. Your World Hunger Day is observed on 28th May. Remember this date also, friends. Days and themes are important for your examination. The theme for 2021 is Assess Ends Hunger. Okay, remember this theme also. What is the aim? Why we are celebrating this World Hunger Day? We are celebrating this day to raise awareness about more than 820 million people, friends, are living in chronic hunger worldwide. Okay, if we discuss the aim, or if we, you know, celebrate this day by spreading awareness, we will be discussing, we will be thinking about some measures also to remove this hunger. Okay. So friends, additional information is the World Hunger Day is an initiative by the Hunger Project, first started in the year of 2011, and this year it marks the 11th annual World Hunger Day. I hope you remember this, and the theme of the day is Assess End Hungers. This is important for your examination. So friends, it's time for the revision test, and everybody has to answer this. International Day of Families, friends, is observed on Dash May. You have to tell the date here. And every year, and the theme for 2021, you have to tell the theme here. Dash has won the Excellence in Meditation Award at World Health Award 2021. Let me know what is the name. Okay, friends, and with this, we complete the video. And thank you so much, friends. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, do hit the like button and do join me in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care. I see you in the next video, friends.